council has joined.
Good day today.
You remember your feed, Bill?
Very good.
Well, we are very glad to have you.
How are you?
I'm very glad to meet you.
Jointly hosting this event with the Council for Quality Growth, and I cannot thank my friend and colleague Michael Paris enough for not just partnering on this event, but all the great work that they do in this community for and with all of us. One thing I would just mention before we get into the program, this past year, as a result of an initiative that the Chamber hosted several years ago called Envision 2030, a group started to take a look at how we can define and measure quality of life in our community. And so for about 3 years, this group met to try to identify a path for how to go about doing that. We identified several hundred measures for how we could go about that, and we published, for the first time in this community, a quality of life report. And it's a list of leading indicators as to how we are doing as a community, everything from schools, crime reports, that sort of thing, to tell us where we really stand as a community. It is available on the Chamber's website, and I would strongly encourage you to take a look at it. There's some really great information on there. And with that, I am going to turn it over to my dear friend, Michael.
Thank you, James. It is a privilege, again, our seventh annual State of the County address together, and it is, as James said, a great privilege to have the Forsyth County Chamber of Commerce as a partner once again. I'm Michael Harris, again, President and CEO of the Council for Quality Growth, and once again, I'd like to welcome Chairman Pete Amos and our Board of Education Chair, Darla White, here today for their address. We have a lot to learn, and you guys are doing a great job here in Forsyth County. As well, I'd like to welcome our U.S. Senate and congressional representatives, our state legislators, and our city and county officials, as well as all of our sponsors, members of the council board, members of the Forsyth Chamber Board, and all of our guests. What y'all do for these two organizations make them run every day as volunteers, as contributors, and supporters, and I can't tell you how much we appreciate it. And on behalf of the council, I'd like to thank all of you who invest in the council, everything you do for the council. If you're not a member of the council, we have a table out front. You can learn more about us, but we are a trade association representing the growth and development industry. We work throughout the metro area, primarily with our local governments, on the regulatory atmosphere, along with the state government, to help us develop quality projects, quality growth initiatives throughout the region. So please, please learn more at the front table. I'd like now to welcome Bill Russell, one of our board members, part of the leadership of the council. Bill is president and CEO of Russell Landscape Group. He's a premier member of the council and one of today's luncheon sponsors. He will give our invitation in place. Bill.
Thank you, Michael. It is a pleasure for Russell Landscape Group to be today's luncheon sponsor for the state of the county here in Forsyth. We have a lot of clients in Forsyth County, and I'm extremely pleased to be here with you. And our most recent facility is in Forsyth, right down the street or up the street, however you want to look at it. I guess it's up the street, Mike. But on Penley Road. But our company just celebrated a milestone of 27 years in the industry. We continue to be Georgia's largest landscape contractor firm. And as I mentioned, we're very, very proud of our work in Forsyth. In fact, today I'm very honored to have several of our team members here, including Matt Dempsey, who's our Forsyth branch manager. You guys just stand up, and so this audience can see you. And they are some of the best. I just say that Russell's comprehensive services span throughout the entire Southeast. We employ about 500 employees of some of the best leadership in our industry that are all committed to excellence and all committed to unmatched services within the landscape contract community. You've heard that old adage that I really love, that if you want to predict the future, you've got to create it. And I don't know about you, but I'm tired of whining, Michael, about the past 5 years of economy, and I'm excited about the future. And I can tell you that our leadership this past fall adopted a very bold strategic plan to not only revamp our operations internally, but externally. And we committed to purchase state-of-the-art data system to measure every service we provide. And we also embarked upon hiring the best and brightest in our industry. And As of January, we've hired 10 new leaders with an average of 22 years experience in our industry. So we're serious about turning the economy. As that old saying goes, 60% don't want to hear your problems, 40% glad it's happening to you. So if you'll stand with me, as you can tell, I'm very proud to have a business in Forsyth County, and I'm very, very bullish on the future for Russell Landscape Group. You'll bow with me. Our most gracious and kind Heavenly Father, designer of all, enabler of hope, we do marvel at your generosity toward us, and we thank you for many blessings of life. We ask, O Father, your choice favor and your richest blessings upon this great county of Forsyth, both its citizens and its public servants. Father, we ask that you'd meet us at our critical points of need, direct us in ways that inspire and challenge us all to enhance the original quality of life. Father, I praise you for fine work at this Forsyth Chamber of Commerce and Council for Quality Growth under James McCoy and Michael Parris, and I just ask you continue to bless their leadership. Now we ask your blessings on our event and our meal. In his name we pray, amen. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please enjoy your lunch. Chairman of the Council for Quality Growth and President of Winter Construction Company, and I want to welcome everyone here today. Thanks for coming, and please continue to eat. We're going to go ahead and start our program, but we'd love for you guys to just keep eating, okay? A couple of quick announcements. When you leave today, there will be Georgia Trend, the most recent copy of the Georgia Trend magazine outside, where on page 35, there is a very nice article highlighting Forsyth community with pictures of Chairman Amos, Forsyth County Manager Doug Dara, and Chamber President James McCoy. It is a very, very good article that highlights all the economic development activity and everything that's happened in Forsyth County, which all of you know is a lot. And James wanted me to let everyone know that he will be autographing copies after launching for a small fee. Okay. Are you serious about that, Jim?
All right, so let me now transition introducing our sponsors, without whom obviously today's event would not be possible. So first, join me in welcoming our title sponsor, Glenn Jackson, Administrator of Northside Hospital, Forsyth. Glenn.
Thank you, Brent. Good afternoon, everybody. How are you? Good? Everybody have a good meal and a little fellowship. We want to thank Chairman Amos and Board of Education Chair Darla Light for taking time out of their busy schedules. We really look forward to your comments today and all your reports and celebrating these many accomplishments and milestones that we're going to be highlighting today. This is one area in particular that I want to celebrate, and that's the recent announcement that came from the study Robert Wood Johnson Foundation did with the University of Wisconsin Population Health Institute. This is the second year in a row that Forsyth County has been proclaimed as the healthiest county in Georgia. So 2 years in a row, healthiest county in Georgia. So on behalf of all the healthcare providers in our community, we just have two words for you. You're welcome. No, I'm kidding. However, as much as we would like to take full credit for that, this noteworthy distinction, further examination of all that data, you know, it really reveals a very different picture. I want to share with you very quickly some of the report highlights. Let's start with a lower than expected premature death rate. These are all factors that led into the healthiest county of Georgia distinction. These are some hardy staff of folks up here and coming in Forsyth County. And they've determined on their own to live very long and prosperous lives. So I would just say nothing beats a great gene pool to get you started, right? Next, let's look at health behaviors. Lower than expected rates of adult obesity and physical inactivity, coupled with greater than expected access to recreational facilities, can at least in part be attributed to our wise use of our $100 million green space bond and the hard work on the parts of the Parks and Recreation Department, the board, and the foundation. Next is the statistics of low rates of sexually transmitted infections. I'm just gonna leave that one alone. And low motor vehicle crash death rates. Some of those can be linked to our education provided in our schools, the health department, and civic organizations like LEADER program in our community. Then if we look at social and economic factors, a better than expected high school graduation rate is the result of decades of efforts and initiatives by our school board and our school system and their determination for us to have a world-class education environment. The years of focus in this area has had a direct impact on our ability to secure the University of North Georgia as a permanent institution in our county and an asset to the landscape of our region. Now next, let's look at low unemployment rate and low numbers of children living in poverty. We can thank our coming Forsyth Chamber of Commerce strategies that support a robust business climate and an ongoing collaborative efforts in the public and private sectors that focus on economic development. Another statistic that landed us in the healthiest community category is the low rate of violent crime. We're fortunate to have the expertise of local law enforcement agencies and their continuous dedication to public safety. And finally, let's look at the physical environment indicators, where we have the safest drinking water, which is a testament to our city and county public utilities and their commitment to service above the standard. The state of our community overall then is very healthy. I believe that the data in this report bears witness to the fact that we're healthy because we work together for a common good. We all love coming in Forsyth County and we want it to be the best place for our residents today and for generations that will come. Thank you for allowing your community hospital, Northside Hospital Forsyth, to be just a small part of this rich fabric. It's our privilege to serve your healthcare needs and a privilege to be our sponsor today for this event. We can pledge to you our ongoing support and cooperation for the collaborative effort that keeps Forsyth County the healthiest and, I would add, the happiest place in Georgia. We'd also like to extend our congratulations to our school superintendent, Buster Evans, on his imminent departure from Forsyth County Schools, unfortunately, but he's going to assume a higher calling in leading the educational initiatives in the Georgia prison system. In the spirit of local comedian in our area, who you all would probably know, I guess it could be said that you might be a healthy community if your superintendent leaves to serve time in prison as an employee, not an inmate. Thanks, Buster, for keeping our reputation strong. You'll certainly be missed, and you built the successes on our success on the success of your predecessors. So will our new superintendent be building on the healthy state of our schools from the legacy that you provided. So thank you for that. And thank you all for letting us be a little part of today's event and giving us a chance to be here with you and get to hear all the excitement today. So please enjoy today, and I look forward to hearing the great results. Thank you.
Thanks, Lynn. Okay, I would now like to recognize the rest of our sponsors. Please hold your applause until I get through all of them. Our platinum sponsor is Georgia Power. Our luncheon sponsor is Russell Landscape Group. Our chairman sponsor is Gas South. The program sponsor is Winter Construction. And the dessert sponsor is Kaiser Permanente. Our gold sponsors are American Proteins, CH2 and Hill, and Wakefield Beasley and Associates. Our silver sponsors are Edward Andrews Homes and Moreland Altavelli Associates. Our bronze sponsors are Hayes James and Associates, Jacobs Engineering, and Lipscomb Johnson Sleaser Daly and Smith. And our patron sponsors are Brown and Caldwell, Choke Construction, Safe Built, and Sword and Shield Enterprise Security. So a round of applause to all of our sponsors. I'd now like to invite our chairman sponsor, Bill Weatherly, business development manager with Gas South, to introduce our speakers. Bill?
Thank you, Brent, and good afternoon. At this time, I would like to invite our speakers to join me at the stage here and take a seat. They will remain up here on the stage throughout the program, throughout the question and answer portion of the program, and we can go from there. First, I would like to introduce the Forsyth County Commission Chair, Mr. Pete Amos. Chairman Amos was elected in 2010 to serve as the District 1 Commissioner for the 2011 through 2014 term. This is the second year he was selected by his fellow commissioners to serve as chairman of the board. Prior to serving on the Board of Commissioners, Mr. Amos served for 6 years as chairman of the Forsyth County Planning Commission. He's a small business owner whose family has lived in North Georgia for generations. He and his wife, Catherine, are very active in the community. Please join me in welcoming Chairman Amos.
Good afternoon, everyone. You may notice I'm just a little handicapped today, so we're trying maybe a little slow in the speech side. But, you know, a man after 30 years of marriage should know better than question his wife than she does. So, it's my honor to be here today and provide you the state of the county and the Forsyth County State of the Government. Thank you, Chamber of Commerce, for putting this on. Council Quality Growth for organizing this outstanding event. And I'm also honored to speak alongside the Board of Education Chairperson, Honorable Laura Wyatt. I've known her for many years. I'd also like to recognize my fellow county commissioners at this time. Cindy Jones-Mills, Brian Pam, Jim Ball, Todd Levent are all with us today. Our county manager, Doug Beer, Assistant County Manager, Kim Merritt. And we have numerous employees and county officials in our attendance today, so I want to welcome them all. If you would give them a good hand of applause, I would appreciate it. County government, our county government, employs almost 1,300 people, and they do a great job for our county. They day in and day out, they provide all the services to our citizens of our county. So these are the true people that we honor today from Forsyth County. It's the people that get out there and do the job. And I wouldn't be remiss and not to thank everyone here today. Because without you, without the community, the business leaders who make Forsyth County what it is, we would not be here. You have contributed, you all have contributed to the county's success. And we will guide, and you will help guide us on to the future. So without you, people from the community, businesses, we would not be here. But today, I'm going to kind of not going to do a philosophical, lots of numbers and things. I'm kind of get to the point person, down the earth guy, and everybody knows that. I'm a little country sometimes. I don't know what that means, but. What we're going to talk about today, I think Jody put this together, I think it's great. It's like a puzzle. Forsyth County has many moving pieces, and luckily it's going to be a big puzzle, so most of us can put it together. But few of those puzzles as kids that we put together, and even as adults, we have retired. I'm sure there's a jigsaw puzzle in everybody's house here that we have finished or haven't finished or going to glue it to a board somewhere, but it's laying around the house somewhere. The puzzles are completed when a bunch of small pieces come together to form one big picture. When you look at one piece, it's hard to understand what the big picture is going to be like. But as pieces come together, you realize what the big picture is going to be. It comes to mind, you know what it is. And that's what Forsyth County is all about. It's a number of things. It's a number of quality services, our facilities, our programs, and people that together make Forsyth County what it is. An absolutely great place to live. I wouldn't live anywhere else. So what are those pieces? You know, we got to put this puzzle together. Well, the foremost number one piece is our public safety. We have dedicated men and women who work tirelessly to protect our community. Our 911 center answered 214,000 calls last year. 214,000. Our fire department conducted 365 child safety seat inspections. And our fire department does that. If you make an appointment, if any of you grandparents out there on the have any children that want to put a new car seat in, make a point with our car department and they make sure it's installed correctly. And nearly 400 smoke alarms or batteries were provided to seniors and residents in need. Our first responders take pride in what they do and they work tirelessly around the clock to provide those services. Support the efforts the county places an emphasis on making sure our public safety infrastructure keeps up with the demands of the growing population. Last year, we opened fire station number 3 in the northwest corner of Forsyth County. We're not done, we got more fire stations open. So one by one, we opened stations all around the county. And all of you are aware of our new jail and courthouse located in downtown City Cumming. If you haven't seen it lately or haven't been through Cumming, you're missing the sight behold. They've started the brick pattern, the brick panels on the side, and it's coming together quickly, and it's going to be a beautiful building. It's something to be proud of, and we thank Women Construction for that. They're doing a great job. But you have to remember, our existing courthouse and jail was built in 1976. Were you born in home? County population, 24,000. Now we have, in the latest estimate of the count, we have almost 195,000 people in this county. What a tremendous amount in 40 years. It's amazing. But you can see how badly these facilities were outgrown. I mean, with 24,000, almost 200,000, we had to do something. So we had SPLOSH, went to the people of Forsyth County, and they approved SPLOSH 7 to build these facilities. So what a great moment for Forsyth County to step up and take command. We're on track for material completion of the new courthouse this year, December 2014. Material is basically through everything but a few things inside of it. And hope the opening will likely be first quarter 2015. Judge Biden will hold probably the first case in that new courthouse. We hope he does, and hope he is proud to do it. The jail will be completed, material completed in early 2015 too. And one of the best things about our jail courthouse being so close is we're going to have a bridge connecting the two of them, which will enhance all security while we transport prisoners from the jail to the courthouse. It may be amazing to walk, all of a sudden drive under a bridge in Forsyth County and look up, the sun goes out for a second. So It's going to be unusual. We also have two park facilities that have been constructed. The McCaskberry Road is almost complete, a 255 parking unit site. It will be completed probably early May, early June, and be open for the public. And we've always started on the Mason Street. There used to be a kind of a ugly green building there that I'm glad it's gone. It enhances the beauty of the county already, it's a city coming. But we demolished it and was getting plans ready to build the Mason Street parking deck, 450, 4 1/8 unit parking space for citizens of Forsyth County and Cumming, Georgia. And we appreciate everybody's patience. I know lately the traffic has been bad in town. It's going to be bad for another 6-7 months. We hope that once these parking decks are completed, the traffic will be a lot better. We can move things around. So this thing about the last 10 months, since I was here before, we've had the groundbreaking for two great facilities, and the county is moving incredible. Like I said before, all these projects were approved, funded by SPLOST 7. The voter approved, the citizens approved. It wasn't commissioners, it was the citizens of this county that wanted these projects. They made them possible. They put a lot of trust in our officials to carry this through. And we're making sure we spend every dollar wisely. I pay taxes like all of you. I don't want my money wasted. I want it spent in a wise manner that takes care of our county. Also, we got a new animal shelter. We have a lot of animal shelter people that just love it. I mean, it'd be open, I think, in early June, Mr. Mayor, right? A beautiful facility located off County Way, off towards 400. If you haven't driven by, looked at it, go visit it. It's something the county will be very proud of in years to come. We also have an extension of the Big Creek Greenway. We're adding almost 3 miles of this popular multi-use trail. The work is being funded by the Parks, Recreation, and Green Space Board, voter approved in 2008. And plans are underway for additional parks that were funded by this board in the northern portion of the county, which has been lacking in parks for a while. But now we're going to build the Lanerland Park, Eagles Beak Park, in a Mack community park that's set down. And these will add over 500 acres. These aren't all green space. They will have some rec fields and community activities at these places, rec center. But these will add more than 500 acres to our recreational system. We are planning to add 6 new miles at the Sunny Mountain Preserve, a great place to walk, and improve us to Charleston Park, which we took over from Corps Engineers. We're adding 6 miles of hiking trails and a new dock for the community, for the citizens to use. You know, these amenities like the Greenway, the great parks, a great thing for South County. And as Pat Lynn said a week just about ago, that it was 2 years ago, the healthiest county in the state of Georgia, and we appreciate that. But I think they left Jay Fine off that sketchy. We wouldn't have been up further, would we, James? Education is very important to our county. It's another piece of puzzle. It may be the biggest piece of puzzle out there again. We have an exceptional school system in this life. We'll talk about that in a second. But what I'm proud of, too, is we have campuses of both Lanier Technical College, which you are sitting right now in the conference center. Until they had this conference center in this school building, we had no place to meet. We had to go out of the county or use some restaurant we converted, or a gym or something we converted to have a meeting center. So we're so proud of the facility we couldn't have it. Also, we have the North Georgia, the University of North Georgia, located in the city of Cumming, Forsyth County, right off Pebble Mill Road. So what two great things to have for our county. We opened our newest library off Post Road. If you haven't seen that, go by. It's a wonderful thing. Our library system is great. Another crucial piece of infrastructure is critical for every community. But even more when you experience the kind of growth we've had. And we've heard it. Elected officials have all heard it. Traffic sucks. No wonder we haven't had any dicks. You can't go fast enough in this county. We've heard it. Census data keeps us up, but we're still the fastest growing county state. So we're on the bottom. It's like last year we completed the expansion of our water treatment facility, which enabled us to treat water more efficiently and more capable to produce more raw water from Lake Lanier. And work is underway for the new shake rag water reclamation facility in the southern portion of the county, scheduled for completion in 2016. This has also been about in our long-range sewer and water plants for many years. And now back to transportation. I know we've all, as I said, we all talked about it. We can't get to our work, can't get to school. Many businesses depend on transportation. And that's one of the reasons they looked at it. They want good, sensible, well-used, moving people through Forsyth County transportation. So the SPLOST program used to provide a lot of money for our transportation system, but the county was in a downturn just like the rest of us since 2006 and 7. Our SPLOST 6 came up almost $60 million short from projections. And this was $60 million we were going to use for roads. And so we were just basically short. We had no money. People said, why didn't y'all start ahead? Well, if you want to pay more taxes, we were always going to do what you want, but if we didn't have the money, it didn't come forward. But we're coming out of it. The board made some sensible decisions, and I think very sensible decisions, to pull some money out of our general funds and start the improvements of Old Line Road, Mullinax Union Hill Roads, and get these started as soon as possible. It's a slow process, but we're getting started. We will repay the funds out of the SPLOST 7 account until we pay back our general funds. So we've heard from residents. We've listened to y'all. We've taken these thousands of emails and trying to respond to what y'all want to move traffic better through our county. We also do have a plan for Castleberry Road, controversial road, that has been on three SPLOST programs, not SPLOST 7, plus 5, 6, and 7. So it's been there. It hadn't been hit. We went ahead and going to fund that road from the general fund to get it built. Four lane with a 20-foot raised median. Earlier this year, the Department of Transportation allocated $1 million for a shovel-ready program. They didn't pick Castleberry Road. They wanted us to pick a shovel-ready road. Castleberry Road, right-of-way has been purchased since 2009. Almost over $10 million we had spent already on right-of-way. And it was, plans have been drawn, plans have been approved, and so we picked Castleberry Road for $1 million. And for that, I want to thank our state delegation for helping with that road. That happens with all the transportation in the county, and we appreciate what you do. And Bethany Road is next, another four-lane road. It's been on the phase, if you notice, the first phase is between Highway 9 and Castleberry Road. It's scheduled to be open sometime in June, July. And I'm like many people, I'll off the Bethview Road, I'll be glad when it's done. So, and the county's currently acquiring right away the second phase from Castleberry Road to Highway 20, another four-lane road with median. And it's going to make a lot of people not have to go all the way to come, they come back around. So when these Castleberry, Bethview, Mullinax, Union Hill Roads are all improved, we will hope to notice improvement in traffic. And we'll leave some of it up to the state to finish out how to do the rest of it. From roads, a fire station, to an animal shelter, a new courthouse, you know, there's no question that Forsyth County is not making progress. But all this takes money. And I will have to tell you, Forsyth County remains financially sound. In fact, it's one of the three counties in the state of Georgia that has a AAA bond rating. AAA bond rating means we can borrow money at lower cost. We can do transportation, roads, water sewer projects at lower cost. So through all this time and trouble, we have kept our bond rating the same, AAA. We continue to have one of the lowest tax rates in the metro area. People love it here. They move here because one of the first reasons why don't you move here, the tax rate's low. But, you know, maybe we should raise the tax rate to the movers last. But right now, we're in, you know, we have had the same budget for 4 years. So we work hard to spend our money wisely. We're in the early stages of developing our 2015 budget, and we certainly hope to keep it, the mileage rate the same. I said we've had it 4 years, and hope one more year will be great. One thing that's very positive, our sales tax receipt showing a positive trend. That means the economy is doing better. Sales tax collection for 2013, which includes the new TABT tax on vehicles to replace the sales tax. We're up over 9% in 2012. So it shows our economy, people are spending money. People come to our counties to pay, and every sales tax dollar comes to us. Residential building permits are up. 2,790 building permits were issued in 2013, over 500 more than 2012. So we're growing, we're building. So people want to call Forsyth County home. The development you're seeing today all across the county reflects this. As the population continues to grow, it is of course important to remain focused on economic improvement. The county is proud to partner with Chamber of Commerce and a development authority working together to attract healthcare, retail, manufacturing, technology businesses, as well as international corporations to our county. We can't grow without businesses, and they are attractive. We're proud of our Chamber of Commerce and Development Authority. The results of this partnership are clear. Economic development projects from last year, we stated before, we've improved to 600 new jobs and generated over $58 million in capital investment. The 5 months into this year, we've surpassed that. We've got 8 economic development projects going on with economic impact of $72 million in the first 5 months, new capital investments. South County's growing. It's the star of North Georgia. People and companies are invested in our county, and they're a big part of the puzzle for South County. Their investment translates into tangible results. Jobs, 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 and money for the county, increasing our tax base. We had one of the lowest employment rates in the metro area. That's a great stat to be proud of. So when you look back at South County, you see all the pieces of the puzzle, from public safety services, parks, education, infrastructure. They all come together, but there's one piece of the puzzle that's missing. The glue that holds it together, the thing that makes the puzzle steady. And it's each and every one of you here in the building today. Without community and business leaders like this, they want to push South County ahead, see its potential, we would not be able to complete that puzzle. So you, in the audience, the reason we are here. For South County is growing, and we're growing good. So I want to thank you for being in our community and being part of South County. We all love it. I know y'all love it. I wouldn't be here if I didn't love it. At this time, I'd like to share a short video of the 2000 State of the County video highlights of some of the site projects going on. Trust me, I would be through quickly. Video? Video?
In July, Forsyth County opened a new fire station number 3 in the MAP area of northwest Forsyth County. Funded by SPLOST 6 and impact fees, this new fire station will serve the community well for many years to come. Providing professional fire emergency services to the community is our daily mission. We're doing our part to help keep Forsyth County safe.
In 2013, we completed the expansion of the Forsyth County Water Treatment Plant. This enables the county to treat additional water and allows for increased efficiency, saving both water and money. Construction of the new Shea Craig Water Reclamation Facility is underway, with a completion expected in 2016. A part of the county's long-range sewer plan, this facility will operate under a permit that's very protective of the Chattahoochee River, reinforcing our commitment to water quality and conservation. We're doing our part to continue advancing Forsyth County's infrastructure while maintaining our commitment to being good stewards of our precious water resources.
The county's new animal shelter will be located on County Way, just off of Georgia 400 in northern Forsyth County. Funded by SPLOST 7, the new 13,700 square foot facility was designed to provide proper care to abandoned, stray, or neglected animals, and to promote adoption, public education, and collaboration with local animal adoption groups. We're doing our part to care for Forsyth County's animals.
Work began in late 2013 to extend the Big Creek Greenway. Funded by the voter-approved Parks, Recreation, and Green Space Bond, Phase 4 of the Greenway will add approximately 2.85 miles to this popular multi-use trail. In 2013, we also installed turf fields at Coal Mountain Park and Sony Mountain Park, and continue to offer a wide variety of athletics, recreational programs, and camps. We're doing our part to make Forsyth County fun and active.
The Forsyth County Public Library has one of the highest usage rates in Georgia. In August, we opened the new Post Road Library in West Forsyth County. Funded by SPLOST 6 and a state construction grant, this is our fourth full-service library branch. We're doing our part to combine traditional library features with modern technology to make Forsyth County's libraries the best they can be.
Ground was broken in the summer of 2013 for the county's new courthouse and jail, which is currently being constructed in downtown Cumming. It was funded by the Bowman-approved SPLOST 7 program. These new facilities will feature enhanced security and overall improved efficiency. The citizens of our great county are doing their part to advance Forsyth County's judicial and public safety systems. Jody's going to be having sample puzzles given out pretty soon. So. Well, I want to say I appreciate the chance to talk to everyone here today and give you an update on the county. I've shared a lot of information with you and look forward to sharing any more. Any questions you have later or contact the County Commission and they will answer them for you. But I would like at this time to ask you to do something for us. We are starting a brand new initiative for Forsyth County for our new board. A lot of people don't know about this, but we're trying to, I guess, create a new logo for our county, a new Forsyth County space. So I'd like for everyone here to visit the county website at forsythco.com and take a brief branding survey. It will be available through next Thursday, May 8th. So I want to thank anybody in advance that will take a few minutes out of your day and take this branding survey for us. On behalf of the Board of Commissioners, Forsyth County government staff, all employees of Forsyth County, we thank you for the opportunity to serve y'all today and the future to come. Thank y'all for coming out. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I want to thank you and the board for their commitment to serving this great community in Forsyth County. Next up, we have the chair of the Board of Forsyth County Education, Ms. Darla Light. Darla has served as an elementary and middle school PTSO officer, and she's coached youth and middle school basketball. She's active in the North Forsyth 400 Rotary Club. She and her husband are proud residents, along with their three children, of Forsyth County. Ms. Light.
Good afternoon. I'm glad to be here. I have allergies, so if I have to stop and call, please pardon me. I'd like to thank the Chamber and the Council for this event. It's a great event. Last year I did it and I was nervous for a week. And this year, it's just an honor to get to come and tell you where we are and what our school system, our plans are. We're very excited. I want to thank all my cohorts from the Board of Education who are here, Joey and Candy and Jennifer and Valerie, and then the other board members, Nancy and Tom and Kristen and Buster, the superintendent. They're here for support and to heckle me, I think, but I'm glad they're here anyway. And I'd like to just get started. Not a big long PowerPoint, it's just four slides, so don't panic. For South County Schools, has 40,000, and I think it's up to 900, maybe 14 students in 35 schools. We keep growing every day. We're the seventh largest of 195 school systems in Georgia. Last year we were ninth, and this year we passed Henry and Cherokee counties to move up to seventh. There's our growth. We're growing about 1,700 students per year. And we've added 14 new schools since 2003. There's only, we're ranked 179th out of 195 school systems for total per pupil expenditures. And we're the lowest in the metro area. There's actually one that's almost double us. I won't call any names because I don't want to make anybody mad. But our per pupil expenditure is really low. We also have the lowest millage rate of among the 14 metro Atlanta districts. The closest is Fulton County, which is 18.5, and that is still 2 mils. We're still 2 mils less than them, and there actually is one around us. Again, I won't call any names, and their millage rate is 23.98, which would be 7.5 mils, a little more than that, over what ours is. Some of the highlights for our school system, several years ago, we made it one of our priorities, along with the chamber, to increase our graduation rate. And we started some new initiatives. One was called the Propel, that was with the chamber and businesses to work on our graduation rate. And last year, we had the highest graduation rate among Georgia's 20 largest districts. So that was really a great accomplishment for us. We were all so excited about that. Another initiative that we had, it was called the 2400 Challenge with the Chamber and businesses. I'm sure some of you have heard of that. We worked hard on that several years ago to increase our SAT scores. Sure enough, we had the highest district SAT scores in Georgia last year. So, you know, when you set your mind to do something and everybody works hard and joins together, it all works out. We have one school that is a national blue, that was named a National Blue Ribbon this year, and one that was a Georgia School of Excellence. In the National Blue Ribbon School, there's only 260 in the whole nation, so that's quite an honor to have one of those in our county. All of our high schools were recognized by the Georgia AP STEM and AP STEM as Georgia AP STEM and AP STEM Achievement Schools. This is for the science, technology, engineering, and math. And Forsyth Central High School had the top, was recognized as the top Georgia high school STEM program. So we started that program maybe 2 or 3 years ago, and we were very excited. They've really come a long way, and I don't know if any of you know much about it. It is an awesome program. I went there and stayed about 15 minutes, and I was like, they were so over my head. It was embarrassing how much those kids are learning. We're number 8 nationally for the large district use of technology. We have over 1,000 visitors. We have people come, in years past, we've had people from South America and Canada. They come to tour our schools. We have what we call a BYOT, which is Bring Your Own Technology. That's what Pete said, oh, you've got it on the iPad. And I said, BYOT. So I'm trying to practice what we preach. But they come to see our technology and how we use it for personalized learning for the students. It really gives a lot of individualized learning, so each student has the opportunities that they need. Some more highlights, of course, I don't know if redistricting was a highlight, but it was a necessity. That's always a big hard thing to do, but it was something that had to be done this fall to relieve some schools that were just severely overcrowded and to repopulate some schools that had seats. So we did that, and that will take effect in the fall. And we also completed the state facilities plan recently. And with that plan, we qualified for $78 million of state entitlement funding. Now, that doesn't mean that the state's going to write us a check for $78 million because everybody completed a facility plan and they only have a limited amount of money. So I think sometime in June we will hear exactly how much of the money that we will actually get. We have a continuous improvement plan that we are always working on, so when our SACS accreditation comes, we're ready for that. We have a workforce development, which really we have a great initiative on that. So many great programs thanks to the business around. We continue to partner with the small businesses around the county to develop a workforce and to have our students career ready. And on a side note, I'm going to get a little political right here. I was at the superintendent's debate last week in Forsyth County. And there were some of the candidates there, and they were totally against businesses having anything to do with schools. They were like, they should, and as my experience here in Forsyth County, our schools would not be half what they are without you and your businesses. I mean, these businesses come in and they partner with our schools and just do all kinds of wonderful things. And so I urge you to, before you vote for state school superintendent, to see where they stand and on things like this, because I don't know where Forsyth County Schools would be without our business partners. Next, we have the upcoming budget and what our plans are. We're, of course, we're going to have with the 1,700 student growth, we have to have more teachers, and we're going to have to add additional learning cottages to accommodate student enrollment growth. And that is actually, this year, it will cost us about over $1 million just to add those, to lease those learning cottages. And so, as you know, that's why we have a bond coming up. Our teachers have really suffered through the last few years. They have been cut days. Their health care costs have gone up. They all make less now than they made a few years ago. And so hopefully this year we're planning to put all of our, have a full 180-day calendar with 190 days for teachers, and to provide the step increase, which is the teacher raises. That's what we're hoping to do with our budget this year, because we've stretched them and we've had all these, you know, the highest SAT scores, but you can only push somebody so much, and we're to that point now. So we're hoping to reward some people for their hard work and their sacrifices that everybody's made during these hard times. And we're happy, of course, you know, as many of you know, I'm sure that Lynn talked about, Dr. Edmonds will be leaving us at the end of June. And while my head knows that the opportunity that he has to make a difference in so many lives is great, my heart hurts because we're going to be losing such a great role model and leader. He's a man of honesty and integrity who has moved us forward in the most trying times to be one of the best school systems around. And I feel blessed to have worked with him and believe I'm a better person because of it. We'll miss him terribly, but thank goodness that he's leaving us in such great shape. I have it on good authority that everyone in the state wants his job. So the application pool is expected to be large and talented. A little bit of our timeline on the application pool. We are going to, the deadline for applications is actually tomorrow. And then we have the GSBA is actually vetting the applications for us. We're going to appoint an interim on May 15th, and hopefully we will be able to have somebody hired and have them in by early fall, is our plan, if the application pool is as great as they say it's going to be. I now have, as most of you know, we have a bond referendum coming up May the 20th, and it is so key that we pass this bond referendum to continue to be one of the best school systems. I was at West Forsyth last week making a video for a teacher thing, and there was two kids there, two 15-year-olds, and they were so professional. They had me up at the camera, and they were like, you know, the lighting and getting everything right. I mean, I felt like I started sweating. I felt like I was in a studio, and the teacher said, well, how does she look? And mom said, well, we might want to get a white sheet. I'm thinking, what's a white sheet? The teacher said, oh, really? He said, well, there's a little darkness. You know, he didn't want to say she's old and wrinkled, but he just wanted to light my face up. But the kids, they made this wonderful video, and they were so professional, and they had such passion. And I was telling them, you're doing such a great job. And they said, yeah, but if that bond passes, we're going to get this and this, and they're going to move this to there. And I just thought, we can't fail our kids. You know, these kids have passion. They were talking about what they wanted to do with this. They're learning at this age. And we cannot fail our kids by not passing this bond, because it's the kids that are in school today that will suffer. But I have a short video for you to see.
Forsyth County Schools is home to 40,821 students in 35 schools. As the third fastest growing school district in the nation, Forsyth County Schools adds 1,700 new students a year. This year, Forsyth County Schools moved from the 9th to 7th largest school district in Georgia, surpassing both Henry and Cherokee County Schools. The district operates at a high level of fiscal efficiency and delivers strong achievement results. Forsyth County Schools is one of the lowest per pupil expenditures in Georgia and the lowest millage rate in Metro Atlanta. This year, Forsyth County Schools earned the highest graduation rate among Georgia's 20 largest school districts, and also the highest SAT scores in the state. Given the fiscal challenges residents faced during the recession, the district has not held a bond referendum since 2007 to generate funding for capital improvements. Therefore, Forsyth County Schools spent a year building the new strategic plan and an additional year completing the facilities plan to identify the current and future needs of students and staff. The result was the Board of Education's decision to provide voters the opportunity on May 20th, 2014 for a $195 million bond referendum, which will address four areas: improvements to existing schools, school safety, technology, and growth. Improvements to existing schools for proposed projects such as career technical and agricultural education, CTAE, high school equipment updates and program expansion, special education technology and equipment, renovations and improvements, including but not limited to electrical, flooring, painting, plumbing, kitchens, and HVAC. School safety for proposed projects such as upgrading decade-old video cameras, improving school visitor check-in systems, and implementing new communication devices for bus safety. Technology for proposed projects such as upgrading network switches to support faster network speeds, expanding data storage for teachers and students, enlarging the Wi-Fi network to provide more coverage for BYOT, replacing aging school projectors, and upgrading video and audio systems. Growth for proposed projects such as purchasing new school buses, additions and modifications to existing schools, the construction of a new middle and high school, and funds to purchase land for new schools. If the May 20th, 2014 bond is approved by voters, funds would be available fall 2014 and work would begin on projects at existing schools continuing for 4 years. The financing for this bond is structured not to increase the bond debt millage rate as long as SPLOS, Special Purpose Local Option Sales Tax, is extended by voters. If the May 20th, 2014 bond is not approved by voters, the proposed projects, including improvements to existing schools, school safety, technology, and growth, may not be completed. The deadline to register to vote in the May 20th, 2014 election is April 21st. Voter information, which includes advance voting dates and locations, is available at www.forsyth.k12.ga.us/bond. The site also includes bond project lists and enrollment and financial information.
In closing, on behalf of over 40,000 students and 5,000 employees, I want to thank you, the members of our community, for continuing to support Forsyth County Schools. I'm not only a graduate of Forsyth County Schools, I'm a mom of three graduates from Forsyth County Schools, and this year I became a grandmother to a future graduate. I tried to tell Jennifer we needed a slide up of my grandson so you could see the cutest baby in the world, but I got vetoed. But seriously, there's nothing really more important than our family, and especially the future of your children and our children and grandchildren. Living in Forsyth County has been such a blessing, and I want you to know that the school district is honored that you trust us with your sons and daughters, who will be the future business leaders and civic leaders. Thank you.
Thank you, Chairperson Light and Chairman Ames. Let's give her another round of applause. All right, when everyone registered, you were asked to submit some questions for these folks, but basically, y'all done such a great job of your presentation, you've already answered all the questions. I mean, one of them for Chairman Ames was give us your opinion about transportation, which you've already done. So with that said, we've probably got a couple minutes for any questions from anyone from the audience, maybe a couple. Does anyone have anything? Yes, sir.
This goes to Darla, and one of the things you said you went to a meeting last week about with some superintendents and about how they don't agree that jobs should be or companies should be involved with the school process. Is that correct?
That's correct.
Very glad that you disagree. I am a business owner, and we see the end result of these people coming from the schools. My company is absolutely full of spot here, and we are in the service industry, so we tend not to have college-educated people. That's just not who comes and cleans and services swimming pools. One of the main things that we have a problem with the employees or prospects that come in for an application is that they don't even know how to make a resume. They don't know, it's very hard to find people that can even spell the word maintenance. So I know when I find somebody that can spell maintenance, hey, I need to focus on this guy because I know that he has potential. So very glad that you disagree with them, but very alarmed that they don't see that. I know Georgia Department of Labor has implemented something, and forgive me, I don't know the title of it, but where they work in conjunction with some high schools to educate prospects on how to do resumes, how to be introduce themselves into the workforce. Does Forsyth County work in conjunction with them on that program, or do you know what I'm talking about even?
Valerie, we have a new Dr. Hall is actually our new CTA person, and she has hit the ground running. We have all kinds of programs where we partnership. We have businesses in the schools, and we are also working with, I think Siemens has a program down at South Forsyth to try to train kids to be, not everybody's gonna go to college and get a four-year degree. But that doesn't mean that they can't be ready for a good career when they get out of school. And that the career pathways is something that the state has been talking about, and that's something that we have been focusing on. And that's why I was so alarmed last week when I heard, I mean, we depend on our businesses in this community to make our schools what they are and the partnerships with them. And that's why I was so alarmed, and that's why I brought that up, is I want everybody, just before you vote, don't just pick out a name. Please go and look at what their views are, because without businesses, Forsyth County schools would not be what we are today. And that's why in the bond, if you notice, we had some career tech money, that's what that's for, to advance that kind of thing and get kids ready for not just, you know, college, completion of college. Thank you.
I have one more question. Okay, thanks again to all our sponsors. Thanks for coming. Hope you come back next year and have a great day. Thank you.